Okay, so
my brain hurts.
So it's a man that has to receive all this part of the soul, and we have to analyze to know how exactly, how we learn from the Torah exactly about all this part of the soul.
Mm-hmm. So the soul of Mashiach.
Everything is in the Torah. God leave us trail to find anything tracks about Mashiach. Mm-hmm.
So the soul of Mashiach was, when he said that I am that I am, the soul of Mashiach was in Moses, was in David, was in Adam. So Mashiach is pictured as Adam, Moses, David, Joshua. He is all of them.
Yes, he's, he has something with all of them. One of them can be the nefesh, another one can be the ruach. Wow. Moshe can be the neshama because Moshe mm-hmm. is the mental, wow. etc. So
yeah.
Wow. The ruach can be Eliyahu, mm-hmm. concept of oh, matat, yeah. of the word of angel, etc. So each one of the level is related to another world. And this three
world,
they call them in
lights.
In the verse that I just said, you will be seen with the sun before the moon, one, two generations. The nefesh, ruach neshama, related to the three generations. A generation in Kabbalah means another world. It means it's like another generation. And under this is the moon, that is the physical body. Okay? It's like Esav. It's like Esav. Is like nefesh, ruach, neshama, is the full generation. Before it means above in Hebrew, it's not only before in time. Before the moon, one, two generation. So if the moon is full generation, one and two is full generation. Then is the chayal, what is the sun, represents the sun. And then is the yechidah, what is the soul of Mashiach from the first coming. Okay, so all these things have to be together in one person, and only after the building of the temple, the Beit HaMikdash, it will be seen with, from all the world, like he promised, like it is written that he will come with Atik Yomim. So it will be seen only after the temple will be built. The temple will be built maybe 40 years after the beginning of the coming of Mashiach. Let's say the Pidyon HaBen, it can take more 40 years until we have peace in all the world. And before this happen, we still can have that. Maybe this is not Mashiach Ben David, this very good king that is a good, fantastic thing in the world. Maybe it's not. Because if he didn't build the temple, by the halacha, is not yet for sure Mashiach ben David. Only after he built the temple, we are sure that it's Mashiach ben David, and only then, it's not any more problem, the miracle of seeing Mashiach all over the world. It's not, the world is already another world, everybody has spiritual possibility of vision,
perception,
of dreaming, like you have probably already. The world is a different world, and then Mashiach will be seen came from above as well, like we see we came like the Beit HaMikdash will build the temple from below, and this, in the same time we can see that it came from above.
Yeah.
Wow, that's above. So
it's already a reality. The world is already in the kind of condition that everything that we do below, he came from heaven as well. Mm-hmm. So but now we can see it. Mm-hmm. So as well, immediately after the building of the temple, Mashiach will be seen. And then like the verse say, will be seen with the sun before the moon, one, two generation. In the same verse in Tehillim, it is written that before the sun, Yinon Shmo.
His will be done.
In the seventh chapter of Tehillim, it is written with the sun. And in the, I think the verse 17, it is written before the sun, lifnei shemesh, yinon shmo, v'yitbachu bo kol goyim. All the nation will be blessed from him. Yinon shmo v'yitbachu has the acronym of Yeshu. Ufno zayin. This is the first coming. All the nation will be blessed from him. In the second coming, with the sun and before the moon, have the acronym of Yeshua with the Ein, in the beginning of this four words, and in the end of this four words, we have the word Mashiach in the right order. We have four words with Mashiach, with Yeshua,
in one
and
sen-
with Mashiach.
In one sentence.
In one four words.
Wow.
So it's something fantastic from the point of view of Gimetia.
You can write it on the table if you want.
Yeah,
you
know, we
just
can do
pick
it.
Just one example so people can see this.
Yeraucha im shemesh ve'lifnei. Maybe this one right better.
Sorry, we got kids.
You will be seen with the sun and before the moon, one, two generations. In Shemesh, Vilifne Yareach. We feel the word Yeshua.
Oh, my.
And here, with Mashiach, Mashiach, in the right order, something very rare, because there are 24 possibilities, I to write Mashiach, it's four letters.
What verse is that again?
This verse equals 1,000, what is Mashiach ben David plus Mashiach ben Yosef in Gimetia,
1,000,
plus Bet HaMikdash. So, it's an end for what I just said, that Mashiach will be seen only with the temple.
Yep.
There are many fantastic things here.
That makes a good
wow.
And
the,
it is a, yeah. Something to...
Leave it one second.
Yes.
No?
Yes.
One
so
second.
Can we get a picture of that?
Can we get a picture of that?
Ariel,
like
please. Ariel,
that.
Can you move?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When he said that you will be down on earth as it puts into the joining of the two worlds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or more than two worlds. If you want to get into that, it's crazy.
From the kitchen,
yeah.
On the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
Can you erase it for us?
You gonna erase it?
Just kidding. No. Oh, right there on the refrigerator.
Yimach, but we said that the secret of Mashiach is this word Chen Noach. Yinon Shmo Ve Baruchu Bo Kol Goyim. Yinon Shmo Ve Yitbaruchu is Yeshu. This has to do with the first coming. These three words equal this number. 1, 1, 1, 0. That is the most important number that have to do with the concept of the Trinity.
No, leave it alone. People want to take a photo, Ariel. Ariel, people want to see that. No one's seen that. No one's seen that. write it again so people can see it.
Okay.
Let people see.
I want to write more things.
But let people see.
I want to explain this number.
But let people see first.
The world was free world. You know, flow, very deep, Baruch. In the moment I have acronym, it's always, we have a very interesting gematria when we just check the word that acronym appears on. We don't do all the verse, we just take this two word, because it has the acronym of Yeshu. Yinon Shmo with Bahu. His name is Yinon and will be blessed. So this three word equal 10 times the concept of Even Chen, a jewel stone, a stone of Chen, stone of grace.
Gemstone.
Capstone or
so Even. What is mean a stone, the Mashiach called stone in many places. Yeshua in order number equal to 53. What is a stone?
A diamond.
Yeshua Yud is a 10 letter, Shin is a 21 letter, Vav is a 6 letter, Ayin is a 16 letter. Together equal 53. What equal Even? What is father and son? Av, Ben, together.
Ah,
Even.
I love that.
Av, you write like this Av, and you write like this Ben. So Even is a father and a son together. Even. Chen, our sages, Chen is the Holy Spirit. So when the Gematria of 111, 10 times 111, that is even more precise. If I just to understand this number 111, I think we talked about this before. We said that it's 3 times 37, right? 37 is a 13 prime number from 1. 13 equal 1. 3 times 1, 3 times 13 equal God is 1. Hashem, Echad. Okay, so each one of these things 10 times. Okay, so you just a hint that is very important number of the concept of Jesus coming, is the concept of the Trinity in his first coming with no the Ein. You know, if I do the gematria of Yud-Kevav is the name of God. I just write the number. Miriam plus Miriam. Equal in Gematria, Jesus, Yeshu. Why we don't have the Ein? Because we don't have a physical father.
The Holy Spirit.
Jeez.
We don't have a physical father, so even if born with the Ein, is going to lose it. Because the Ein represents the tribe of Dan.
The body.
The body. The skin of the snake, what is all the physical reality, is the secret of the letter Ein. They could not owe that God puts on the man after the sin. Could not owe. It means he give us, instead of owe, what is light. With Aleph, he give us owe with Ein. This is O and this is O. This is O of light, this is O from the snake. The rectification of everything in this world has to do with the rectification of the skin, with the letter Ein. Okay? The word Chen appears 70 times in the Bible, but with Ein. So it's a very big subject. Understand the concept of the letter I. It's a big, big teaching about this. But this why we can see that Yud-Kevav plus Miriam equal Yeshu, not Yeshua, the way the Jewish call it. It means This is the way they're supposed to call this. And this represents the Yechida. Yes, in order number, you call Yechida. 37. What is the soul of Mashiach?
Well, you wouldn't get that reading Matthew, what?
Is that why when he was here the first time, he told the scribes and the Pharisees, you are of your father, the devil, or the serpent? He supposed because they were trying to fit, you know, or they were...
They're really, Mashiach ben David is the secret of the Ein. The two Ein equal 10 times David. Ein is 72 times Ein is 10 times David. So the concept of the two eyes, what is the sun and the moon, is a concept of that have to do with the tree of Judah. From one side is Mashiach ben David, from the other side is a priest, Mashiach. That came instead of the evil force in holiness.
Trying to process everything.
I've been with these guys, not just Ariel, but Theo for the last 24 hours, and my brain is just mush right now. It's been an awesome time. It definitely has been. The Shabbat work. Amen. And maybe do some, you know, soul cleansing.
That's why the New Testament is very Kabbalistic.
It is.
The only way to present the New Testament to Judaism is to learn Hasidut, Kabbalah, Hasidut. There's no other way. It's above, much above just revealed part of the Torah. The book of Yohanan is one of the most deep books. And it's so deep that a nation can be wrong about it and do idolatry. And he gives the answer about this. He says, you are all God and son of God. No problem. In the moment we understand that you are all God and son of God, who is God and son of God? Who receives the word of God? No problem. It's not idolatry anymore. The biggest problem between Judaism and Christianity is this problem. All what has to be understood here, that this belongs to each one of us, and then, no problem. Not anymore idolatry, we can go to a church, no problem anymore. It's not, it's a big problem, it's really a big problem. It's not a problem that nobody knows what, how can we fix it. He gives the answer. In the book of Revelation, he says that he will give us the Haman Aganus, the hiding Haman.
The hidden man. Hidden man.
And then he will give us
stone.
Oh, a white stone.
Right.
Ever. Levana. Levana is the way we call the moon. It can be called Yareach, it can be called Levana. Even equal Chama, the way we call the sun. It's the Shemesh and it's Chama. So when we talk about the sun and the moon, it is a couple of names, that is Shemesh and Yareach, and it is another couple of, that we call them Chama, Ulevana. So Even, that is a stone, equal 53, what is Chama, and Levana is Levana, is the way we call the moon. On top of this white stone, equal 140. What is the two Ein? On top of this, he will give us a new name.